Well, I hope that caught your interest just a little. Oh, what a way to start the morning. Does that make you feel just a little bit better? Children? Well, let's see what else we have that might catch your fancy.
I'll get you a little pretty and a little dog, too.
We're so glad that you joined us. There's only one problem. It's yours, of course. Now you can't leave. And for being
I took my visitors all over the house. I had them searched well.
Mommy,
I led them at length to his
we
chamber.
Have I shall story just for you.
Don't. Please don't. Please don't do this to me.
18 months ago, this 29-year-old woman lived every woman's worst nightmare.
No, no!
Where do you go to put the pieces back together? She got help at a rape crisis center. They got help from the United Way. Thank God the United Way got help from you. The United Way. It brings out the best in all of us. A public service of the Advertising Council.
We're back. Live, I think. Are we live, children?
Yeah! Ah!
Oh, do we have a crew for you. Good morning, Rosa.
Good morning, Bernie. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. A little sad to hear that you're leaving, but I wanted to call to wish you good luck, good health.
Hold on a minute. Crew, I can't... The sound in here is low, and I can't hear when you guys start. So speak again, please.
Okay. I wanted to call and wish you good luck in your future endeavors. And I wanted to wish you good health and the best of everything.
Thank you, Rosa.
I have a 4-year-old daughter who, she told me, if you don't call Bernie tonight, I'm going to cry. She's been waiting up to tell you goodbye. She wants to speak to you.
What's her name?
Her name is Megan.
Let me speak to Megan.
Hi, Bernie.
Hello, Megan. How are you?
Fine.
Good. What are you doing up so late? Huh?
I'm here sitting. I'm playing with my mom while I go to sleep.
Oh, you are?
Mm-hmm.
Did you want to get on the radio? You know you're on the radio right now. Did you know that?
Yeah.
You did? Well, can I ask for something? Huh?
Huh?
Can I get a kiss?
Huh?
Can I get a kiss?
No.
I can't. Said, oh no, you don't get a kiss. I don't get a kiss.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Just a little kiss. Can I get a little kiss right now?
Yeah.
All right, give it to me. Oh yes. All right. I love that. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, when you go to sleep, you're gonna have to go to sleep real fast, right?
Yeah, I go to sleep at my mommy.
You're going to sleep with your mommy?
Yeah.
All right.
I'm going to sleep there for her.
Okay. Well, listen, you take care of yourself, you hear?
Yes.
All right, darling. Good night.
Good night.
Take care.
Hey, bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Just get her mommy back on. Rosa?
Yes, Bernie.
She's delightful.
Yes, I think she's just a little excited. She's been waiting up since 12 to hear you.
Well.
And she loves you.
I love her, too.
We're going to miss you.
Listen, you take care of her and take care of yourself.
I certainly will.
Please do that.
Okay, be good, Bernie.
God bless.
God bless.
Take
Bye.
Care. It's 12:48 at WWDB. Let me say this so that it's clear. If I've tried to do anything in 5 years, of course, every day I speak to adults, but we've had dialogue with one another, hopefully for the purpose of children. Share a couple of things with you. Some 40,000 children a day die in the world. 40,000 children a day die in this world. They die of hunger. They die of pestilence. They die of disease. They die of neglect. They die because they're murdered, beaten, battered, neglected, and abandoned. But they die. 40,000 a day. And folks will shake their heads and they say, isn't that terrible? But all of those children die because adults are not being responsible. Think about that. So when we have a conversation and we start talking about things that need to be done, think about who they need to be done for. People who are looking for a new Cadillac or a new BMW or a larger house, all of those personal attainments are great. Those things are wonderful. The question is, who's paying for it? And I'm not talking about in dollars. Be aware of that. That's not to put a damper on you. That's to say that there's a price being paid and being demanded from those in the world who are least able to pay the price. That's what the conversations are about. Let's go over here. Good morning.
Good morning, Bernie.
Hello, Catherine. How are you?
Good. Gonna miss you.
I'm gonna miss you, folks. I really am.
Really? I don't know what we're gonna do without you.
Listen, it'll all move on, and there's gonna be somebody else in here, and the name of the game is reliance on self. Not a single individual. Not me. Not for sure. My feet are made of clay. But in yourself. That's the biggest thing.
Right, but you will really be missed, and you've really done good work. And I wish the best for you, because, like I said, it won't be the same without you.
No.
And I wish you the best things in life, because you've given the best of it.
Well, thank you.
And I received your picture.
Good.
And my nephew.
I say good.
She's the one.
Somebody got it. I told you.
And my nephew, Royce Howard, says, that's him, Aunt Catherine.
Oh, Royce?
You remember Royce?
Do I remember? Ask Royce who named him.
Okay. Now I want to know, is there any address?
Yes, I'll put you on hold, Norma, to give it to you.
Okay. God bless you and keep you.
Thank you. God bless.
Okay.
Hold on. It's 12:52 at WWDB. We got a whole crew of people in here this morning. This is some kind of big Richard is in here. How you feeling, Rich?
Pretty good. Hanging in there.
You all right?
Yeah.
You and I still take. We both taking a load of pills. I got a pocket full of pills. I think doctors are in the pill business. If I must not know medicine, give him a pill. Just two things, give him a pill or cut him, I can forget that. I'm not giving you no money to cut me. No. I know too many neighborhoods all over the world. I can go in and act crazy and get cut for free. I can give you no money to cut me, man.
When it comes to talk radio, others may try. But no one comes close to WWDB. Nobody does it better.
Forecasters are predicting a cold and bitter winter to make up for the past hot and humid summer. Now's the time to think about keeping warm this winter while saving on your heating bills with a new Kerosene. I'm going to do it again, right? Samerica, gotcha. Samerica electric heater. Imagine a portable electric heater that is about the size of a 6-inch cube, and it can provide instant heat to the largest of rooms, impossible to ignite combustibles, even tissue paper. Delivers 5,200 BTUs and can maintain room temperatures for 24 hours automatically for less than a dollar. Kerosun Samerica is clean and maintenance-free. Now, there's no smoke, no fumes, and no refueling hassles. This lightweight is a heavyweight. I'm talking about Kerosun Samerica, the ceramic heater that will revolutionize the electric heating industry. Kerosun Samerica is available at all Mr. Goodbye's and Boscoff's locations, also at hundreds of surrounding dealers. For the dealer nearest you or dealership information, call Pesco Distribution Center in Norristown. Now, that number is 1-800-441-5114. 1-800-441-5114.
96.5.
Hula hoops are a thing of the past. Seems like some things never last. Just look at all we've left behind. Sock hops and saddle shoes come to mind. But the important things, they don't go.
And fads come and go, but U.S. savings bonds will always be around. Yesterday's solid investment is a great American investment today. Bonds pay competitive rates like money market accounts. They're free from state and local income tax, and you can buy them where you work or where you bank.
So just remember yesterday when you set out for tomorrow.
U.S. savings bonds, the great American investment. Find out more. Call 1-800-US-BONDS.
When we set out for tomorrow, when we set out for tomorrow, when we set out for tomorrow, we won't get a job that way. I know.
Ain't no tomorrow.
No tomorrow. John, good morning.
Good morning, Bernie.
How are you?
All right. This is John from Sound and Soul.
John where?
John from the group Sound and Soul.
Oh, yes.
Yes, and I just wanted to say that I'm definitely going to miss you and want to thank you for having us on the air those couple of hours when you did, and that was very, you know, I appreciate that.
You are more than welcome, my friend.
And definitely going to miss you, and I think you had one of the best voices, and it's really going to be missed in this market.
Well, thank you.
I want to wish you good luck and success in whatever you know, your next endeavors are.
All right. Hey, listen, thank you, John, for thinking of us.
Thank you.
Take care now.
All right, you too.
All right, my friend. I don't know who was listening the other night, the other morning. My brother Richard came by, he and his wife Frances, and my brother came on the air and said good morning and made me sound like a tenor. Blows me away, man. He goes, bloom, good morning. He might stick his head in here.
Everyone else has.
Yes.
That would be nice. I haven't seen Richard for a while.
If my nephews come in here, then the room's going to be crowded. It's going to seriously be crowded in here. It's going to be something. When I was a kid, I used to go behind my brother and listen to him on the telephone, and I used to try and sound like he did. I never made it. I never made it, man. I'm about to turn 53 years old. I still didn't make it. He still walks in the room and goes, bloom, and the walls shake. I can't do it. I'll tell you the story about Melvin Franklin.
No, Uncle Bernie, tell me.
Tell you the story.
Tell me, Melvin.
I was on the air here at HAT. This is a number of years ago. And the way the studio was set up and the way the console faced, you faced away from the door, so anyone coming in the door, you couldn't see them unless you looked through a rearview mirror that we had up. Well, the mirror wasn't up that day for some reason, and I heard someone come into the studio, and I just didn't pay any attention to it, and I was talking. And over my right shoulder, someone's head. And the head said, good afternoon. And it was all the way from the sub-basement, this huge voice. And in this business, a voice can wipe you out. And he wiped me out. And I knew who it was the minute he said, good morning. And it was Melvin Franklin of the Temptations, who will wipe out a basso profundo. Big what? Pipes. big, big pipe. Basso. Basso, profundo.
I thought you were swearing
there. No.
In Italian.
No, I know how to do that. No, we won't go.
We're kidding, Frank.
Awesome.
We're kidding, Frank.
No, Frank, we're not doing that. We wouldn't do that. Good morning, Florence.
Hi.
Hi, Flo, how are you?
Okay. First of all, I want to wish you a happy Halloween, you and the crew there.
Thank you.
A happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. This was going to be your PR person. For the Rat Patrol?
Yes, how you doing?
Okay.
With the Rat Patrol. Da, 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 da.
Never came about.
No, it didn't. Good idea that just didn't happen.
Yeah.
The next person who comes in and sits in this chair, put that together for him.
Well, you know, I hate to say this, but this is your last night. It's my last night.
No, don't do that. Because and I say that because give whomever else comes in here at least the same chance that you gave me, please. Because that's what happened. The folk in this town gave me a chance. They said, well, we don't know who this guy is, but we'll give him a shot. And that's all any of us can ask for.
Well, I learned so much, you know, from you.
Wow.
And it's just not going to be the same.
Well, you know, things change, and very often the change can be beneficial. So hang tough. Listen, Flo, I got to run because the news is about
to get in. I want to wish you all the luck in the world.
Thank you, darling. God bless.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Stay with us. We've got news for you from WWDB Philadelphia.
From ABC News, I'm Ashley Martella. A lot of attention will be focused on Wall Street when the stock market opens in the morning. Investors and analysts will be anxious to see the reaction to news of the second biggest corporate merger in U.S. history. Pending approval of the federal government and Kraft stockholders, the nation's number one food company has said yes to a buyout offer from Philip Morris. It offered $106 cash for each of Kraft's outstanding shares. More from ABC's Kathleen Dulaski in Washington.
The cigarette manufacturer announced it is paying $13.1 billion to gain control of Kraft, the country's largest food company. The price is high, but the company wanted to expand its base since cigarette consumption isn't what it used to be. Besides its cigarette brands, Philip Morris already owns several familiar food products like Jell-O, Oscar Mayer, and Maxwell House Coffee. Now the company will acquire many more famous foods such as Velveeta cheese, Parquet margarine, and Philadelphia cream cheese. But several industry analysts say the merger won't really affect consumers. It doesn't give Philip Morris a monopoly on any food products, since the product lines of the two companies are quite different. Kathleen Dulaski, ABC News, Washington.
More after this.
The Crime Prevention Coalition and the Ad Council present McGruff, the Crime Dog.
Listen to this song and you'll get some tips that'll help take a bite out of crime. If you're making modest money or are in the chips, you should help take a bite out of crime. So in your home or store, always lock your door, night or day, wherever you stay. Cause when you lock up, hey, the robbers go away, and it's taking a bite out of crime. When the weather's too hot to keep your windows shut, here's a way to take a bite out of crime. Found a nail in the frame about 2 inches up, and you could take a bite out of crime. And when you're out of town, let your neighbors know that you're not around so that they can go and check your home periodically. That's taking a bite out of crime. Start doing, take a bite out of crime. Take a bite out of crime.
Take a bite out of crime.
He used to publicly cringe at the word, but Sunday, Michael Dukakis labeled himself a liberal. The Democratic presidential candidate likened himself to what he called the liberal tradition of Franklin Roosevelt, Harry Truman, and John Kennedy. He made the remarks during campaign stops in California. The latest Time magazine poll shows Republican George Bush with a 10-point lead over Dukakis. The Dukakis camp says its internal polls show their man picking up steam in some key states. In Philadelphia Sunday, Bush said he didn't believe his lead was weakening, but vowed to continue campaigning as if he were the underdog. The wife of former Philippines President Ferdinand Marcos is due in federal court in New York late Monday morning. She and her husband are charged with using over $100 million in stolen Philippines funds to buy prime real estate in Manhattan. More from ABC's Dennis Trout in New York.
Imelda Marcos came in from Honolulu by private jet and traveled in a limousine to her hotel in downtown New York. Late in the afternoon, she attended services at St. Patrick's Cathedral amidst a clutch of reporters and photographers following her. At her coming arraignment, she faces charges including racketeering and obstruction of justice that could carry penalties of fines up to $1 million and a prison term of 50 years. She's expected to plead not guilty. Dennis Trout, ABC News, New York.
In Los Angeles, President Reagan was honored Sunday night for his commitment to Israel and Soviet Jews. Mr. Reagan received the Simon Wiesenthal Center Humanitarian Award, and he told the gathering,
"We vow to be vigilant in our battle against those who would follow Hitler's example. This is our cause. To further it, I will presently sign the Convention on the Prevention and Punishment of the Crime of Genocide, and so will affirm America's commitment to the profound biblical admonition, therefore choose life."
Mr. Reagan's appearance at the center came only 3 days after Vice President George Bush went there, also declaring unwavering commitment to Israel. Authorities in Sierra Blanca, Texas, have charged a truck driver from South Carolina with manslaughter after a rampage on a West Texas highway. They say the driver ran at least 9 vehicles off a 75-mile stretch of road, killing a woman. They also say he wounded a constable and shot at a motorist before he surrendered. This is ABC News. A lot of guys don't like to wear neckties, but for at least one man, there's a principle involved in the case of the tie that binds. High school math teacher Bill Webb of Point Pleasant, West Virginia, faces the loss of his job for sticking his neck out. Webb says he hasn't worn a tie for 15 years, and his students can communicate with him better because he doesn't. But the superintendent calls him insubordinate, points out there is a dress code, and says, how can you expect the students to follow regulations if the teachers don't? For the ABC Information Network, I'm Ashley Martella.
WWDB.
How about we go to the movies tonight? Or maybe dancing. And after that, we can go to...
Hey, come on. Let's cut to the dessert. Let's go to my place now, baby.
Well, I...
Hey, come on. We've been dating for weeks now. Movies, dinners, concerts. I really think the world of you. Why are you again spending the rest of tonight alone at my place?
It's not you. I've got some really intense feelings about us, but it's just...
What? Somebody else?
No. Well, it's this AIDS thing.
AIDS? What about it? I don't have it.
Well, how do you know?
Hey, come on. I ain't gay.
But AIDS affects gay and straight people. And what about IV drug use or blood transfusions or past relationships?
You know, I think you're making too much of this AIDS thing, baby.
Making too much? Don't you know getting AIDS is like getting a death sentence? AIDS is serious business. I really think the world of you, too, but I feel it's either condoms or I'll pass.
You know, you're right. I can't argue with that.
I don't want our past to come back and haunt us.
Stop a killer. Use a condom. A message from the Philadelphia Department of Public Health.
96.5 WWDB. We hear you.
We're back with you. We've got the whole crew in here, and our number here, 365-4100. 1-2-1-2-3-1-1-2-3-3-4. Am I getting... Hello?
Hello?
Did I hear an echo?
It was me.
Oh! I'm going crazy, man!
I'll let you look around for a while. Everything else is going nuts.
The loop went out. George is here.
George is here.
Did you see Bobby George?
Yeah, I saw him out in the parking lot.
The dogs are here. My dogs are...
Chef's going to the dogs, Bern.
Mr. Johnson is going to get those dogs tonight, I'm telling you. They're going to get the dogs tonight.
Sure, Brooke.
How you doing, George?
Okay, how you doing?
All right. Dressed up like a sailor?
Yeah, drunken sailor.
A drunken sailor.
It's only kind.
Oh, man, do we have a crew and a half. Did he pull out of the parking lot?
Yeah, he just left as I was coming up.
We'll get him. We'll get him on the phone.
What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do with a drunken sailor? What do you do?
That's right. You mug that. No, 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 no.
Everybody got a Navy yard.
Good morning, Bob.
Good morning, sir.
How are you?
Very good. Just want to tell you I'm a long-time listener, first-time caller, and sounds like tonight I'm a last-time caller.
Well, let me ring the bell. You're my first-time caller.
Good, that took my nervousness away a little bit.
Well, that's the name. That's what that's for. Wait a minute. We have a new ingredient to our sound effects factory. There you go.
Just want to say, I really have enjoyed your show in the past few years. Your insight into people and their problems is just magnificent.
Well, thank you, sir.
I would hope sometime to see you in a political office sometime.
Why would you do that
to a nice man like Bernie?
Bob, I've always made a promise, and every town that I've been in, and that is that I would never, ever take what I do on the air and try and turn that into some kind of political situation for myself.
I understand that. The reason I say what I said was that you are in touch with the people and their problems. And I think some of the people today in our office really are not in touch with the people and their problems.
That's why I keep urging people to look amongst themselves to start seeking their representation. All too often, we keep looking for someone else to lead and to guide us. And all too often, it is that grouping of people who come from a milieu that has nothing to do with us.
Uh-huh. Well,
I mean, the carpenter, the guy who drives the bus, or the cab driver, or the machinist, or the mechanic. They too understand problems because they've got to live through them. If we get back to trying to hold on and appreciate the intelligence that we all have, it's amazing.
Oh, good. Strong point there. By the way, you played two pieces towards the end of your show about half a year ago. One was a piano intro and the other one was something like Be Patient With Me. What was the name or the group that did the piece that began with the piano introduction?
Ooh, one piece I did play was Please Be Patient With Me, The Lord Is Not, God Is Not Through With Me Yet.
Mm-hmm. Who sang that? She was good.
Gosh, my head is swimming. Can anybody remember who that was? I'll tell you what I will do. Before the hour is out, I will have her name for you.
Okay, and do you remember the other one where you had the piano intro? It was a long piano intro, and then the singing came in. That was a wonderful piece.
One was You Are the Sunshine of...
I think that was it.
Oh, that was one, and then there was another one. I'll get you the title of that one also.
Okay.
Okay, and I'll make sure I do it before the hour is up, or at least by 5 minutes past 2 o'clock.
Okay.
Is that fair?
I appreciate that very much, and I wish you nothing but the very best in your future endeavors.
Thank you, my friend.
You're a good man.
Take care of yourself.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. It's 11 minutes past the hour. Do we have more spooky for you?
Yeah. Bernie, you can't be a politician.
No.
Because you can't lie.
Mm.
And you can't steal, and you don't cheat.
I can't steal. I can steal.
Well, there may be some hope for you.
Well, I don't. Let's not get too carried away.
Maybe there's some hope for you as a politician.
Well, if I can't, I've got friends.
Don't worry, we got the bases covered.
Got all the bases. You see, I couldn't be a politician because I would. You're right. I'd tell the truth.
Yeah. You can't.
First of all, I want the job because I need the job. Secondly, it pays well. Thirdly, the hours are great. The time off is fantastic. The pension benefits are fantastic.
Perks are
phenomenal. And ladies and gentlemen, make me your senator, because I'm going to rob this sucker blind.
Let's
vote
for him.
Yeah. I'm going to tell you up front. See, all the rest of them lie. I want to bring integrity. You can't bring integrity to a garbage heap. That's the first thing. It amazes me. I hear politicians talking about they're going to bring integrity to Washington, D.C. You know, that's like saying you're going to get rid of all the flies in a sewer.
don't offend anyone here.
No pun intended. We have the fly in here. I didn't mean to hurt his feelings.
By the way,
so,
Bernie?
Yes.
I got your phone call through.
Yes.
He said he would be most happy to come right back with it. I cleaned it up a little bit, but that's basically what he said.
Is that basic? Frank, your son is so good. He's behaving himself well tonight. See, he knows I can get in touch with his dad.
Well,
his mom is listening.
He would be very happy to come back with
it. Is that what he said? Well, kind of.
Somewhere around there.
That's what he meant in his heart.
Edited for radio.
Okay.
I think it's because he can't lift his arms to turn the car
That's what it is, man.
He was, should we tell everybody what he did?
Robert was working out today.
Yes, he was working out.
He was working on the Nautilus.
Went to the Y. Why?
Why?
Why? We don't know why.
Do you want a can of Raid?
Robert went to the Nautilus. This is about his third or fourth time there.
Yes.
And there was this pretty young lady on the machine next to him, and naturally he didn't want to look like he couldn't work out as well as she could.
Yeah.
So he kept up with her. Hasn't been able to move since.
Not since.
No U-turns. No left turns.
Got him.
No right turns on the car. He can only move the wheel about an inch in each direction. So he's got to go straight just to keep it balanced. But he's a hurting boy. But he meant well.
She
couldn't care less. But he meant well. I asked him, did you get her number? No. Didn't get her number. Didn't get her name.
All he got is a pain in his arms.
He's going to remember her for another week and a half at least.
Every time he moves.
Yeah, or tries to.
Oh, the pain, the pain.
The pain, boss, the pain.
Chris, good morning.
Good morning.
Hello, how are you?
Fine, this is Chris.
How you doing?
I'm doing great. What can I say? You introduced Thaddeus and I in June.
Yeah, I thought it was you.
It's me.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. I'm pretty upset that you're leaving, though. Now when I tell people how we met and they listen, they won't hear you anymore.
Well, you guys know, and I'm real pleased to have things turned out with you.
You have brought us a lot of happiness. There's no way we would have gotten together the distance that we were.
This is one of, for folks who don't know, this is one of our matchmaker couples, and one of our more recent matchmaker couples. They met through the matchmaker, got together, and got married within, 30, 60 days?
No, we met, you introduced us June 10th, we married August 4th.
Wow.
Wow.
Now, how's that? Does that work pretty good? Does that
work? Y'all said it wouldn't work, but it's working great.
I'm sorry?
Everyone says, oh, it's not going to work. You're crazy. You're losing your mind. It's beautiful.
And it just gets better. I love it. You know, yesterday when we were at Wilkie, we had a couple come by, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, and they've got a business up on Godfrey Avenue. And I'm pleased to say that they are going to become a sponsor on the station. Hooray! They came by, and they met through the matchmaker. Now, it's strange because Smitty and I started a conversation doing a swap shop about a barber chair.
Mm-hmm.
You remember that?
Yeah.
And he and his wife met, Ruth. They met through the matchmaker. They are now married and in business together.
That's great. You've brought a lot of people a lot of happiness.
I've had big fun. I have seriously had big fun.
Great.
We've had a chance to meet people, travel. Mark is in here. And
where? I'm sorry.
And
I was watching that fly.
Do you remember the first trip we put together when we went to Canada?
To Montreal.
We have a lot of Montreal travelers here. What are Montreal travelers? Raise your hand. Montrealers.
The jazz and ribs.
Take the A train.
We had big fun. We went up on that train.
It was okay going up.
Going up wasn't bad. Coming back.
It was ripe.
Oh, was it ripe?
Oh.
But we had fun up there.
It was ripe as a stuffed bologna.
Well, we had the stuffed bologna, obviously. It was with us on the train because it was there for a long time.
Yes.
It smelled so good.
Yes. Do you remember the young lady who...
I remember all the young ladies. I don't want to offend anyone.
that was going to miss the train.
Yes.
And for some reason, the train had to stop.
Now we know why. Yeah, yes, yes. I knew I was going to get him at least once tonight, yes.
Oh, boy.
Well, we won't talk about Amtrak.
Am who?
Amtrak, our country's number one welfare recipient. Oh, boy. You know, I don't know what that railroad's going to do if they ever have to go out and work. Hello, Chris.
Yes.
Yes, I'm sorry. I had to take my time and pick on the train company for a while.
Listen, continue to give happiness to people.
Thank you.
And the best of luck to you. We'll always remember you.
And to you and to Thaddeus, I'm nothing but the best.
Thank you.
You take care of yourself. Tell him I said hello.
I sure will.
All right?
All right.
God bless both of you.
Bye-bye.
Take care.
That's nice.
I like that. I like it when people
do nice. Yes.
People do nice, nice.
Well, I guess, you know, we had all those nice matches. Since we know each other, I've become happily single.
just so we can balance things out here.
I'm not going to say anything about the other things you had to say tonight.
That was just a warm-up show before the show, yes.
We've been hanging out for 2 days. You don't know what this has been going through. Good morning.
Hello?
Valian?
Yes?
How are you?
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Thank you. I was down to the rookies down Broad Street, which is Saturday, and we had a picture made together.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
How are you doing?
Fine, and we're going to miss you.
Well, like I said, I'm going to miss this town. We've had fun.
Yeah, and until Jim Brown, I want that jacket. And the guy that had on the sweater, black and white sweater, I want that sweater too.
You want the sweater too?
Are we the one who was picking on my sweater?
they want your sweater, Mark.
I don't know if they sold any cards, but I guarantee you, I could have sold that sweater yesterday.
Easy.
I believe
somebody went in there. Somebody bought a couple of cards in there yesterday.
That's great. Yes, they have some nice stuff there. Beautiful cards.
Bernie?
Yes, sir.
My son wants to say something to you. I
sing. All right.
Hello.
Hello, young man. How are you?
All right.
Good.
I seen you on the picture.
You did?
Yep.
Well, it's got to be in here because I've got a load of mail and a lot of it have pictures in it, and I'm going to be going through my mail through the course of the day. I'm going to find your picture. It's going on my wall.
Well, you live in Washington, D.C.?
Yes, I live close to Washington.
Close?
Yes, I live in Maryland.
You do?
Yes, I do.
I love you, though. I wish you happy birthday, too.
Well, thank you very much. How old are you?
11 and a half.
11 and a half is real important. Yeah. That half is important. Because I'm about to become 53 and a half. Scares me.
Well, my birthday is December the 23rd.
Your birthday is December 23rd?
Uh-huh.
Well, we have somebody else in our studio. Their birthday is December 23rd.
Well, I wonder how the studio
look like in there. Well, let's see. The studio, we have a lot of people in the studio, and it's just a room, and it has a desk in the middle of it, and that's where I sit. And it has a bunch of lights and stuff on it. It looks like a spaceship.
I'm going to miss you, Doug.
Well, I'm going to miss you, too. And listen, you look after your mom, you hear?
Uh-huh.
All right.
And I want a T-shirt.
You want a T-shirt? Oh, I wish I could send you one, but I don't have one. Do we have any T-shirts? Do we have T-shirts? I don't know whether we have any T-shirts. Look on the board. We have anything up there that says we have T-shirts?
I'll tell you what. You get the young... Is it a young man or... Young lady.
We might have. I'll tell you what we might do. Let me put you your mom on hold, and I think we got one or two, and we're going to get you...
I think we might send a collector's item.
That's right, a true collector's item. We're going to send you a Midnight Madness T-shirt. How's that?
It obviously won't fit me, but we have one, some child size, and we'll send them one.
Okay. Hello? Hello?
I think we scared her.
They disconnected. That's too bad.
Oh, well.
I think he turned around and he hung up so quickly. His mother's probably going, what'd you do that for? Debbie, good morning.
Good morning, Bernie.
How are you?
Fine. This is Deborah from Temple Ambler Campus.
Yes.
We all just want to say, you know, congratulations and wish you a lot of luck.
Thank you, Deb.
You've sat with us through a lot of study nights.
Well, listen, you guys have been good company down this way, too, believe me.
Well, I just want to say to you that it's kind of, it fascinates me with the fact that I don't know you, but I consider you a true friend because you have really enlightened me on several things. You went through high school with me, and now you're finishing up college.
Well, now, that's the way I like to travel. That's the way I like to travel.
Great.
Good for you.
And I wish you a lot of luck.
Thank
you. And we all say goodbye. Unfortunately, no one is here because I'm not up at the dorm, but we all say hello.
Well,
and just congratulations.
You tell the crew to just stick by it here.
Yeah. We're having a lot of problems, but we're doing well.
You're going to work them out.
Yeah.
Thank you, Deb.
Bye-bye.
Take care. Oh. I like hearing from the kids from school. Because that works.
I like hearing that they went through high school and in college and finishing that.
Yes.
Gives them a big head start.
That's the one that works. Let me cut this thing down. I cut that down a little bit and we might even hear a little better.
Huh?
Huh?
And we'll take the meat out now.
Say what?
Huh?
People who have been know and who have come in and out of this studio with me over the years know that this place, when I get in here, you can hang beef in this sucker, man. You can hang meat in here. I don't know how anyone can crank the thermostat up in a studio and keep it at about 75, 80 degrees, you know, and it's steaming, you know. And then they go, oh, it's 3 o'clock. I'm really sleepy. I guess so. You're fighting off death. Hold on. Stick around for a while. Do we have good things for people? Yes, we do. Did you want to do something, Norm? No? Okay. I don't want to do that either. I'll wait. I mean, I don't want to be rude. I'll do it this way.
Whoa, I like to see him do that.
I love it, man.
Oh, my.
Oh, boy. Are you ready for another story? I don't want you to forget where you are. We want you to make sure you enjoy this morning. Did you go out and trick or treat?
Come, let's take a walk in the garden.
Hurry, you fool.
I'm coming, Master.
Hurry, you fool. It's getting late.
I know it is, but I'm hurrying as fast as I can.
If you delay much longer, it's going to catch us.
No, anything would catch us.
Your big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing, we will.
Coming, Master.
Hurry,
I'm coming, Master.
Hurry.
Tell me one thing. It's yours, of course.
I know it is, but I'm hurrying as fast.
Well, that's what happens when we find out late that when machine's not working properly. A little something for the kitties. Just a loose person.
Oh, I see.
There's a distinct difference.
This thing will not break a kid. I keep trying to do it.
Give me a stick.
Use a stick.
Thank you, Kim. Here's one that I like, but it didn't work either, and I don't know why. And I thought it had great sound.
I'll get you a little pretty, and a little dog, too.
We're so glad that you joined us. There's only one problem. It's yours, of course. Now you can't leave. And for being so naughty and not listening to Mommy, we have a story just for you. Some people never listen. Some people lose their ears when they don't.
Everybody who knows goes to the Melrose and the restaurant for the most in quality.
Breakfast is now being served at the Melrose Diner. Country fresh eggs, any way you like them. Pancakes, French toast, sausage, bacon, scrapple, chipped beef, and that famous Melrose coffee piping hot. Think you can hold out till you get there?
Everybody who knows goes to Melrose.
15th Street, Snyder and Passyunk.
We're back with you here at WWDB.
Where?
That's a good question. The talk station in the Delaware Valley. 365-4100. No, if those of you who are tuning in and saying,
what the hell's going on in there? That's talk station. Nobody's in there talking about politics. I want to tell the whole world how good George Bush is. I want to tell everybody that he's going to save America.
America.
I want to let everybody know that George Bush is going to be salvation of America. Because that liberal pinko no good communist up north sucker called Dukakis is going to ruin America. And I want to tell everybody how good George Bush is.
The same people who want to tell you how good George Bush is, they're the same people who told you what a rotten lowlife he was when he was running against Ronald Reagan. That always breaks me up, right? It's all right. Don't worry about it.
That's because he learned all this good stuff in the last 8 years.
That's right. Listen, it's all going to balance out.
It changed him.
It's all going to balance out. I just want to leave you with a good thought, those of you who are riding down the highways and byways of America, those of you who are sitting in your living rooms and in your dens, those of you who are in your bedrooms confined to your chairs. Same. Those of you who are sitting back holding on to your bedspreads because you feel that you are lost and lonely, have hope. Do not lose despair. Let me tell you what to do. Let me tell you. Put your hand on the radio and feel the power coming through to you.
Hallelujah.
This morning, we are going to save America.
Say it.
We are going to help America.
Yeah.
I want every loyal, red-blooded, red-bone, red-thinking American to get the hell out of town.
Say it.
Get on a bus. Get on a boat and leave. We
want true blue Americans here only.
Oh, say it.
Those of you who don't believe in the American way, let me explain it to you. Works like this. Rip off your neighbor. Take advantage of your kinfolk.
Tell it.
Don't give a full day's work.
No.
Lie to the IRS.
Yeah, yeah.
Put the worst bum you can think of in office.
Say.
That's the American way. Live well, no matter who you have to step on.
Say.
Don't you know it's you who counts? That don't buy an American car. Get yourself one of them little funny wagons.
Tell us.
Have big fun. Cause you know and I know, you must have a relative over there working in one of them plants, don't you? You ain't nobody left in Detroit, honey. Listen, do what you can for yourself.
Say it.
Doesn't that make you feel good all the way down to your toes?
Oh, look at him wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle.
Reverend Rizlow, say it.
Yes. Yes, and when you finish, when you feel better, when you're standing there rejoicing and you feel all the goodness surging through your heart, send me some money.
Hallelujah! Say it!
The address is...
The address is... Please! Oh, boy.
Reverend Rizlow, you was good.
Oh, boy, we just scared the hell out of the management on that one, boy. Cat said if I, you know, I can hear him now. Rolled over and turned around and said, whoo, if he gives the address here, I'm through.
No.
Oh, I wouldn't do that.
All the people out there that say, don't send cash, don't. Send it here.
Yeah.
And listen, just so that we can be considerate of others.
Say it.
And I do wish that we are considerate of others.
Amen. Tell it like it is.
Don't send change. It might hurt somebody's ears.
Say it.
Just the paper stuff only.
Thank you. I want it to fold softly. All right? Don't send change.
Honey, honey.
That's right. Don't jangle that stuff in my ears.
makes holes in my pocket.
That's right. Start jangling change. You turn around and put a hex on it.
Reverend, big bucks.
Yes. Oh, boy. Oh, there's only one thing. You want to go into the ministry, get yourself a pompadour, a Rolex, watching a big ring, and everything's yeah, all right. Yeah, that's yeah. It. You're ready.
I got it. I'm ready. I'm ready, Rev. I'm ready.
Woo, boy.
Reverend Winslow, what inspires you to say this?
Boy.
When you see the one that I got from yesterday?
Who knows?
The money.
The nice.
Oh, boy. Oh.
All these weird costumes coming in here.
Oh, you just keep changing up.
Everybody get closer to the radio so you can see the costumes.
I wish he'd come alive. Come on,
Bernie, I'm going to go out and change my underwear and be back.
See, there is a guy.
Oh, man. struck him good.
Got it.
Oh, boy.
I
want
to
change your underwear. I'm stripping stuff.
Oh, this is fine. Let me go to these folks. Ruth, good morning.
Oh, good morning. Yeah.
How are you?
I sound like an Irish awake. Oh, I'm going to miss you.
Oh, you're just going to miss the madness.
I'm going to miss that, too, but mostly you.
Well, thank you.
The first time I remember really hearing you after we moved from California, you had on about the Jersey Devil.
Oh.
Well, I was a kid. And we had a Willie's Night. Remember that?
Yes.
Okay. And we were coming up through Elmer and Dorothy, all the back roads from down the shore.
Uh-huh.
And through the Pineys there. And we were young, God, must have been 4 or 5. And my mother said, look out the back window, the Jersey Devil's after us. Well, it was another car back there. And we didn't know it. And, oh, we were petrified. She said, now, if you talk or you fight in the back seat, he's going to get you. Boy, you never saw such good kids coming home in your life.
Oh, yes, you're going to behave then.
Oh, my word, it was terrible.
See?
So,
Mark and I, we thought that we were going to go out and hunt for the Jersey Devil.
We're going to hunt for him.
Yes, we're going to hunt for him. And then I thought better of it.
That you did.
Yes, because I was trying to figure out what are we going to do if we find him.
Interview him. What do you mean?
It's not me. No, buddy. I don't want to talk to anybody who's been living in the swamp as long as he has. And I got news for you. That water is not for bathing.
Oh.
That's not it. You know?
Sell him jewelry.
Sell him.
I'm ready for any eventuality. We're prepared here.
That's right.
Of course. Well, anyhow, I'm Denise's mom. You know, the handicapped kid you were talking to one night?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, she is laughing so much at your show tonight, she says, I have to say goodbye for her. She just can't stop laughing. Really enjoying this.
Well, listen, you please convey our regards to her and our thanks for being with us.
And she was thoroughly disgusted with that four-year-old who wouldn't give me a kiss.
She finally gave me a kiss, though.
Yeah, finally. No. But I mean, with the idea, she says, what do you mean, no?
I think her mother was in the background twisting her arm. Yeah. I'm not sure.
Well, listen, you take care of yourself.
You take care of yourself.
I promise I will.
Enjoy your new position, whatever you're going to do.
It's thank you.
Easy, and we need you around for a lot longer, and I hope wherever you go that we can hear you up here somehow.
All right, listen, I'll make sure that you guys know what I'm doing.
Good.
All right.
All righty.
Take care now. Yep. It's 1:49 at WWDB. Sandra, good morning.
Hi.
How are you?
Bernie?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm finally going to get some sleep. But no, really, on a serious note, I really am going to miss you. I love you. I'm going to miss you, Bernie. I'm very sad that you're leaving, but I'm happy if it means progress for you.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that.
Now, my family has a couple of questions I'm supposed to ask you.
Okay.
Have any pictures left?
Yes, I do.
Do we have two of them?
We're going to try and get a couple out to you. I am going to take about... I'm going to sign these off, and we'll try and get them out to you today. Yes, I will.
Okay, you have any mugs?
No, I don't have anything that I'm going to be giving away.
Okay, that's good.
All right.
And you're not telling us yet where you're going, right?
No, I'll tell you what, if you give us your name and address and so forth, we have a newsletter that's going to be coming out.
Oh.
And give us about 30 days to get all of that put together. And I kept telling people I'm not going away from the Philadelphia marketplace. I'm going to be here. My office is here.
Okay.
We'll be doing business in Philadelphia.
Where did my child get New Orleans from?
I'm sorry?
My child told me New Orleans.
Told you I was going to New Orleans?
She told me.
When are we leaving, Bern?
I don't know.
I'm ready. I want to go.
No, I'm not. I'm not going back to New Orleans. I can't stand that humidity. I love the food down there.
Yeah. But I'm so glad she's wrong.
No, I'm not going to New Orleans.
Oh, well, Bernie, I'm going to miss you, and I hope I will be hearing you again. I participated in some of your programs. I'm a Miss Matchmaker in your trading show and your bong show. Oh, another question.
Yes.
Oh, I don't even care about this question, but I'll ask you. Is it going to be a surprise who takes your place?
Let me share with you. I don't know who is going to take my place. I honestly don't, and I have absolutely no way of knowing.
Huh?
I have not had a discussion with the management or with programming about who is going to come in here.
Okay.
I just have not. If they would ask me for recommendations, I have some recommendations, but I really have no input to that.
You think you'll be a guest on the show?
I have no way of determining that. I have no idea. You know, I think that talk shows should be timely. Mm-hmm. And I honestly, and I'll be candid about this, I cannot see any value in my being a host on a talk program. The time is extremely important for the host of the program and for the people who are listening. And there's so many things that people need to be cognizant and aware of that for me to come back and do a high and buy takes away from the value of the time.
Okay. Well, I just want you to know I love you. We all do. And I'm going to miss you. And the cat will miss you, too, because she grew up with you.
All right. Well, wait a minute. I have to say something to the cat. Hold on.
Meow.
See, I don't want to leave anybody out. Okay?
Oh, you know what? She's so arrogant, she wouldn't even look at the telephone.
Cap said, I know better than that. You know, hey, sucker's not going to fool me.
Say bow bow to your doggies for me.
I'm sorry?
Say bow bow to your doggies for me.
All right.
Okay?
Listen, I might be able to bring them up here now.
Okay.
All right, listen, take care of yourself.
Bernie, listen, God bless you.
God bless.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye. It's 153 at WWDB.
Where's your dogs?
They're down there. I might bring them up now. They get antsy if I turn around. And if here...
You know I miss...
It's not what Max... I know. I know.
Him.
I miss Maxie, too.
I like that dog.
And they're just too big. You know, they get in here and they're fine for about a half hour, maybe an hour. But 5.5 hours sitting in here, first they get lethargic. Yeah. Then they want to play, because I'm sitting here. Then they want to come over and play.
Remember he used to do that?
Yes. He'd be all over the place. Then they want to play. And then after a while, I can't play with them. Then they get mad. All right? Then they get mad. Then anybody coming in here, they want to eat. You know, that's it.
Look at the Corky, the radio talk dog.
Oh, yeah. Mark's dog, Corky. Corky talks on the air. My dogs are too dumb. They don't talk on the air. They don't do
nothing. They just growl.
They just want to
dogs
get
like me
ride.
Can't shut it up.
Yeah. weird dogs. I don't have those pictures. A lady named Maggie sent me some pictures of a Neapolitan Mastiff. Dog is so ugly, it's gorgeous. Dog is huge, man. I mean, this dog is huge. Somebody, I can't remember the fella's name, so please forgive me, but I remember his dog, brought his bulldog, Maxine, by Wilkie yesterday. 7 months old, this sucker had to weigh what, Ed? 40, 50 pounds?
Easy.
And wanted to play. A 7-month-old 50-pound bulldog who wants to play. What do you do when it wants to play?
Play.
You play. That's right. You play, man.
That's the car.
Yes, you know. I saw the salesman looking at him figuring, hey, watch this dog. I got a hunch. See, if you take those dogs and you put them in the trunk, and use them for a spare motor. That's
yeah,
what you do.
Mush.
Hey, hitch that sucker up and go. But bulldogs get obstinate. You know, they turn around and they go 5 feet and they stop and sit down anywhere in the middle of traffic. You know, they stop. I want to see that rascal when it's 3 years old. Because bulldogs are, the uglier they get, the better looking they are, you know? Oh, no. This rascal was just, the biggest, saddest eyes. Orthodontist delight, man. Superior overbite, man. Underbite. Oh. Doris.
Hello.
Hello, Doris.
I'm right here.
How are you?
Okay.
Good.
Is this Bernie?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, yes, it's a pleasure to talk to you. I've been listening. I'm a 4-year listener of yours. And you're so inspirational. And I just couldn't let you, first time caller. And I just couldn't believe
caller?
That I'm saying something.
Wait a minute, are you a first time caller?
First time caller. Yes, but I was listening to you tonight. And so I just couldn't let you go without saying something to you.
I'm sorry?
I imagine it's late to ask for a picture, isn't it?
Well, I don't know what late is. I'll sign one and somebody will put the address on there. That's
what
I'll
that'll do. Be fine, because if I only had a picture of you, at least I could look at that. And then I wish you the best, and I do hope that if you have a business in the city, we will know where it's at so that we can accommodate you if it's possible.
When I come back to the city?
Yes.
Oh, listen, thank you very much.
Yeah, well, you say you're going to have a business in the city here?
I have an office in the city, yes, ma'am.
Oh, an office?
Yes.
Oh, I see. Uh-huh. Well, maybe somehow we'll be able to contact you, the listeners will be able to hear from you, contact you one way or the other.
Well, if we get your name and address, we will be in touch. Believe me, we will.
It would be a pleasure.
I'll tell you what, let me put you on hold, give us your name and address.
Okay.
And we'll get something out to you.
All right.
Okay?
Thanks a million. I wish you the best, because I know that you're going to get it. You're going to have it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay.
Hold on now. Yeah, we keep it, Norman, busy. Yeah, I'm gonna do that, and then we'll fill that out. If I get that to you, Eddie? Okay.
I give it to Fast Eddie.
What the heck is that?
How's the car doing?
Which one? The good one. The old one.
The old one.
Great.
Did you...
hit me in it, in the back.
Somebody hit mine.
Somebody hit mine. He had a Volkswagen Rabbit.
He had. That's right, because yours
was stopped, and the Volkswagen Rabbit, the rabbit died.
Yeah, hey.
Seriously, and mine had about $200 worth of damage, $300.
Well, this guy backed up and hit Mustang.
Did you back up and hit him?
No, I came out of the car, but after I came out, the hand of the Lord rested on me and said, hush.
Hush.
Said, hush. Because you're about to act like you're losing something here, son. Hush.
Did you hush?
But I still felt my back in ignorance. You know, I really did. I was ready to act ignorant.
Call a bag full and a bushel full.
Oh, yes. Yes, I was about to do all of that. And I said, no, behave yourself. See, just be nice. And sue the sucker. No!
Flash.
You know, hey, you know.
What is the extent of...
I don't know. I've got to turn it in Tuesday.
About 42,000.
For them to go over it, because it's not going to be painted in piecemeal.
Mm-hmm.
No, no. No, no, no.
What, the real thing?
No. No.
The real deal.
Yes. The whole thing.
Paint it all.
It's painted. So they might as well. See, because it had to dawn on me. See, what am I doing? I've got an attorney on retainer.
You pay that sucker.
That's
let him work.
You know, why am I going to get in a huff? You know? Have you heard about the law firm I use?
Mm. Do we treat him in how?
No, no, no.
Sue the bad.
Seize him, squeeze him, and hang him. No, no, no.
Squeeze him hard.
Oh, no, I turn it right over to them and go now. See, and then I know where to direct things. See, and then I'm out of it. Then I aggravate those lawyers to death. See? And they don't want me calling because I have their home addresses and their home phone numbers.
And a car phone number.
And you know what time I call people. I call people 3 o'clock in the morning, man. I figure if I'm up, everybody's supposed to be up. You know? Oh, we have to do this? Okay. WWDB, Philadelphia.
From ABC News, I'm Joe Vaughn. Weekending in California, President Reagan came down from his mountaintop retreat near Santa Barbara for an award ceremony Sunday evening in Los Angeles. The president was given the highest award of the Simon Wiesenthal Center. Here's ABC's Gene Meserve.
The Wiesenthal Center is the largest Jewish membership organization in the country and has chosen this year to give its highest honor to the president because of his commitment to Israel, his defense of human rights, and his work on behalf of Soviet Jewry.
The president used the occasion to get in a few good words for his choice in the presidential campaign. Though he didn't mention George Bush by name, the president listed the ways in which the current administration has strengthened its ties with Israel, with a hint that a vote for George Bush is a vote for Israel. I'll have more after this.
Hello. The very fact that you've tuned into this program tells me something important about you, that you've got interest beyond the narrowly personal, that you're intrigued by the world at large. I'm Earl Fell, editor-in-chief of the Christian Science Monitor and of its new monthly magazine, World Monitor. And I'd like to introduce you to World Monitor by inviting you to call today for a free trial copy. World Monitor is a magazine of news and commentary, global, far-sighted, scrupulously balanced, full of energy and color, with lively features on everything from world leaders to social trends, investments to sports. I think you'll be amazed at how thoroughly it satisfies your need to know what in the world is going on.
Call 800-637-2000 for your free issue of World Monitor. Then, if you're satisfied, pay just $14.97 for the next 11 issues, a full year in all, half off the regular price. 800-637-2000, the World Monitor, 800-637-2000.
With little more than a week remaining in the presidential campaign, Governor Michael Dukakis on Sunday acknowledged that he is a liberal, but a liberal, as he put it, in the tradition of Franklin Roosevelt, Harry Truman, and John Kennedy. The word liberal has become an issue in the campaign. With a special report, here's ABC's Peter Jennings.
Ideology plays an important part in winning mainstream America. George Bush tries to paint Michael Dukakis as a disciple of the liberal left by making issues out of such things as the governor's position on the Pledge of Allegiance and his membership in the ACLU.
I'm not questioning his patriotism. He goes out and says, man is questioning my patriotism, and then all the liberal columnists join in. I am not. I am questioning his judgment.
Michael Dukakis sees it differently.
Of course the vice president's questioning my patriotism. I don't think there's any question about that. And I resent it. I resent it.
Tomorrow at this time, how the candidates stand on their running mates. I'm Peter Jennings for ABC News.
The directors of Kraft Incorporated have approved the $13.1 billion merger offer from tobacco giant Philip Morris. The director of corporate communication for Philip Morris, Tom Rickey, expects good things to come from the merger.
We have joint high hopes of with General Foods and Kraft as our food businesses of being a major competitor, not only in the U.S., but worldwide with such foreign giants as Nestle and Unilever.
If the shareholders and the federal government approve, it would be the second biggest acquisition in U.S. history, topped only by the $13.3 billion merger 4 years ago involving Gulf Oil and Chevron. The Boston Globe says the return of the 65-mile-per-hour speed limit in many states has led to the substantial increase in the number of traffic deaths. The Globe says an unpublished study conducted for the Federal Department of Transportation shows an increase of 18% in the number of traffic deaths on rural interstates last year. The Globe says two other privately financed studies showed similar results. Japanese news reports say two U.S. military helicopters have collided in a training flight over in Okinawa, sending one of the choppers to the ground while the other landed safely. There are no reports of casualties as yet, but the Chinook helicopter is capable of carrying as many as 25 passengers and a crew of four. Authorities have charged a South Carolina trucker with involuntary manslaughter in an incident on a 75-mile stretch of Interstate Route 10 near Fort Hancock in West Texas, in which one woman was killed. This is ABC News. A few sporadic incidents of arson were reported during the night in Detroit, but not the widespread flare-up of vandalism that has troubled that city on numerous occasions in the past. By midnight in Detroit, there were more than 370 reported arrests of teenagers for violating the citywide curfew on Saturday and Sunday night. A police department spokesman indicated for the most part it was quiet, due in part to the presence of about 10,000 adult volunteers who helped patrol the streets of Detroit to put a damper on youthful spirits. For the ABC Information Network, I'm Joe Vaughn.
WWDB.
Where did we go wrong as mothers? We tried to teach you to do right, but everywhere we go, there are bottles, cigarette butts, paper, and trash in the streets. We have to stop and think to ourselves.
Is this the way we brought you up? Can you imagine if everybody littered? Now, the city is growing. It's developing. It's moving forward. Now is the time to put an end to this mess.
And you can do it. If you see litter, can it. If you own a business, sweep your sidewalks. Clean up Philadelphia for the thousands of visitors who come here each year. Clean up for your neighbors. Clean up for you.
Take pride in a clean Philadelphia by taking part in cleaning up Philadelphia. Your founding fathers would never have stood for this mess. And let me tell you something. Neither do your mothers.
Become part of Philip Pride. Do it for your mother.
I love hiking in a forest.
You know, Robin, forests are more than just great places to go hiking in.
They are?
Sure. Forests are homes to lots of different animals. We get wood from forests, and they help keep our air and water clean.
Gosh.
But our forests are threatened by development and people who don't treat them with respect.
Yeah.
To find out how you can help, write to Forests, National Wildlife Federation.
Washington, D.C., 20036.
How'd you know that address?
A Frog Scout's always prepared.
Everyone can become an organ or tissue donor. The Pennsylvania Medical Society urges you to take the first step. Talk to your loved ones and your family doctor. Find out all you can. Then fill out a donor card. It's what identifies you as a member of our greatest medical reserve, organ and tissue donors. Keep the card with your driver's license, but please, don't keep it to yourself. A message brought to you by the Pennsylvania Medical Society and your local county medical society. We're dedicated to your good health.
96.5 WWDB. We hear you.
music in the air. Eddie's got that look in his eye. Little does he know he ain't going nowhere. We got him locked in here.
Who is he?
You.
Fast, Eddie ain't that fast.
Right. That's right. Hold on there for a while. Big Rich's got to leave. What's your mom's name?
Margaret.
Mm-hmm. Glad to say to McDade. Margaret McDade, good morning. Hey, good morning to Margaret McDade. I got to say good morning to Kenny and Peggy, because we're holding Ken's mom hostage here. Dale, don't get excited. Dale, easy, Dale. Mom's safe. She's all right, Dale.
As long as she's got food, we'll keep her on.
Yes, Dale, she's all right. Dale is her other son, and he's out there. He's on the police force. And he said, holding my mom hostage? Where? So, no, don't get excited. No, she's safe. Doctor, we love her.
Another candid shot.
He keep getting all those pictures then, see?
That's cool. That hurt.
Did you remember the guy yesterday who had the camera backwards and took a picture of his eye?
Ladies and gentlemen, you had to be there to appreciate this. We're trying to help this guy out, and he's fighting us all the way.
Guy had the camera backwards and took a picture of his eye. They said, you get the picture? Oh, yeah.
So I remember the lady said, well, turn it around. So he flipped it around the other way, took another picture of his eye from the other angle.
Oh, yesterday was a winner. Oh my goodness.
Some crowd, though.
George, you get something to eat? Let's get something to George.
Somebody
George,
feed that sailor.
Feed that sailor. Get that sailor in there.
That's right.
Let me go back over here.
Here's your cake.
Ashin? Ashin?
Yeah?
Good morning.
Morning.
How are you?
All right.
Good.
I'm sorry it hanged up on you, but the phone quit came out.
Oh, we got you back. Okay. Did your mom call back and give us the information?
Yes.
All right. Very good.
Now, do you know my grandfather?
Yes, I do.
T-Bone?
Yes, I know your grandfather.
You say he's a good singer?
I'm sorry?
Did you say he's a good singer?
I'm sorry. I can't hear you.
I said, did you say he's a good singer?
Thank you. I wish I could hear what you're saying. I can't understand.
A good friend?
Oh, I can't say a good friend. I know him.
Do you know he sings blues?
Yes, I do know he sings blues.
He's a good singer.
A good singer, yes.
One day I'd like to come up to the studio and see how you're doing.
Well, you won't be able to do that because this is the last night I'm going to be in here, son.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
But maybe at another time, another place, we might be able to work that out.
Okay.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, you take care now. It's 11 minutes past 2 o'clock. Let's go over here. Good morning, Francis.
And good morning to you, sir.
How are you?
I am fine. And you?
Fine, thank you.
Good. I've listened many times, but this is the first time I've called and gotten you.
Well, wait a minute. That's for
Yay!
You.
Yay!
We have to welcome you aboard.
Well, thank you, and I wish it were not the night that you're leaving. People say, who's taking your place? And I say, nobody can take your place.
Oh, you're kind. Thank you, ma'am.
Not kind, I'm truthful. I think it was a couple of months ago, you read a perfectly beautiful thing at the close of your show, just before Dominic came on,
mm-hmm.
about love. Do you remember that?
Yes, I do.
And I thought I wrote in at the time to see whether or not I could get a copy, but I guess it got lost in the shuffle.
We're going to try and still get that out to folks.
I really thought it was a fine thing.
Yeah, there were some special request pieces that I had, and I still want to get those out. Give me a couple of weeks and allow me that time to try and get them out to you.
Okay, I won't write in again then, huh?
Okay, no, I won't need it because I have all the correspondence.
Mm-hmm.
And we will make sure that we get it out. It's just going to take me a couple of days longer. I want to tell folks that I'm going hunting, and I'm going for about 4 days, and I'm just going to get out there and I'm disappearing.
What are you going to hunt?
Well, I'm going for game. I'm going for small game.
Okay.
There's a place over in Virginia that I'm going to, and they've got a small game out there, and they stock the place, and that's where I'm going.
Well, good. And I hope you have a good rest and enjoy your new location, wherever it may be.
Thank you.
We certainly will miss you.
Well, I won't be far away, I promise.
Okay, fine. Should I give my address to your...
Yes, ma'am, if you would. Let me put you on hold, okay?
All right, that's fine. And God bless.
God bless. Take care now.
Thank you. It's been very nice to talk to you. Oh, I should say, did you have a wonderful party yesterday?
Yes, we did. We had quite a few people down there, and it was fun.
Well, I was wishing I could be there, but I couldn't. So, okay, well, thank you very much, and good night.
Good night. Hold on now.
Will do.
All right, 213 at WWDB over to Jersey. Bert.
Hi, Bernie.
How are you?
Fine, how are you?
I'm okay, Bert. Bert from down to the museum, my buddy.
Hi.
How's everything?
Good. Michelle told me to tell you hi.
Tell Shell I said howdy, our new budding real estate tycoon there.
She's trying to wait up to say bye to you, but she couldn't make it.
Oh, you guys don't have to say goodbye. You know I'm not going that far.
Yeah. Well, now I can get some sleep. Sometimes I used to set my clock so I could wake up to hear you.
Uh-oh.
And now I won't have to do it anymore.
Yes, you do.
I won't have to do it anymore.
Yes, you will.
I will be able to get a good night's sleep.
No, see, they're going to have somebody in here that's going to make you stay awake.
They're going to have somebody in here, but they won't make me stay awake. Yeah, I've heard you. I started listening to you when you first came on weekends. And I called several of my buddies and told them to tune in, and they're still tuning in to you.
Well, I'm real pleased with that. It's been a good response. I'm just tickled the way people accepted me in this market.
Mm-hmm. Well, they didn't have a choice. I mean, being you're really the greatest.
Well.
Well, I'd just like to wish you the best, and I wish that God will continue to bless you, and I'm sure that whatever you undertake, you're going to be successful because you are Mr. Successful.
We're going to try.
Okay, Bernie.
We're going to try. Bert, you listen, you take care. Tell Shell I said hello.
I sure will.
All right?
Okay.
All right, darling.
Bye-bye.
Good friends. Remember, they went up to Canada with us. In fact, it was her daughter who almost missed the train? Was it Bert's daughter?
Could be.
I can't remember. I think it was. Do 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 do. The memories of Montreal. Don't dwell on the train trip back.
That was the second bus. Montreal trip with the windshield and the tires.
For those of you who don't know, we made two trips to Montreal.
This is a horror story,
this,
folks.
This truly is a horror story.
Take the right night to tell them.
The first, yes, Halloween night, this is it. The first trip up, we went up on the train. And we had a good time. We partied, and the sound was too loud, the sound was too low, and the food was late in getting in there. But we got up there, and it was great. And we got from the train station to the hotel, and we got to the hotel, and everybody went, remember, Mary? Ooh, nice hotel. Ooh, great hotel. Nice place. And we had fun. Right? It was all right.
The pajama party was fun.
Pajama party was fun.
Wasn't I supposed to mention that? No.
Don't tell.
Well, we can tell them now.
Yes. And, put the kids to bed. No. And we had a good time. And then on the way back, we went and got on the train.
Woo-hoo.
Now, wait a minute. See, I have to play appropriate music for getting on the train. That works for getting on that train coming back from Montreal. Let me tell you what Amtrak did not do. Amtrak never cleaned out the Johns. And it was hot in those trains.
And do I remember correctly, the air conditioning was not working.
The air conditioning was not working. So I want you to understand the combination of the John wasn't clean, and the air conditioning wasn't working, and it was very hot. You understand?
Now, just sit there and listen to this story.
Yes, children.
And it was stinky. Oh, it was stinky on that train.
How stinky was it?
Ooh, it was very stinky on that train. And it was very hot on that train.
Oh, you talk. Thank you long for coming over the Platte Bridge.
Let me
for some fresh air.
Without a doubt. Let me tell you something. People are amazing, and the folks who have traveled with us, they put up with the day. They put up some serious adversity, because that train. Mary's over here smiling. Mary remembers real well.
Sure did. I was by them.
Of course, it was a 16-hour train ride.
Yes. Oh, no. It's a serious.
If you ever had gourmet food in the dining car on the train, God forbid the microwave doesn't work.
Listen, I never saw so many people glad to get back to 30th Street Station in Philadelphia in my life. People came out of that train as if to say, thank God, whatever Philadelphia has to offer, it's all right. It's all right. Get off this train.
People kissing the floor of 30th Street Station.
Oh, boy. People had family coming to meet them down the train station. They were coming off the train saying, take me away, take me away.
It was like the hostages coming off the plane. It was just a terrible thing. Sight.
And then we turned around. Later we said, we are going back. People said, when are we going back to Montreal?
I told you they were nuts.
Whacked out.
Anybody traveling with us got to be crazy.
And went up on the bus, and everything was fine. Going up on the bus, it was delightful. The weather was good. The trip was good. People got up there, and they had a good time and undid all those things. We got set to come back. What was it? How long?
You
didn't go.
I wasn't on the trip. I don't
know. It must have been 15 minutes after the buses pulled out of at the hotel in Montreal. We're going down the highway, and the rain starts. I'm sitting to the rear of the bus, and I feel a draft. And I'm saying, where the hell is that coming from? And the next thing I know, I see the front window of the bus fluttering. And I don't see real well, And I'm saying, my eyes are playing a trick on me, please God. And the thing is, and I go moving toward the front of the bus, and the bus driver is going, expletive deleted. Let's put it that way. Because I can't say what he said. I can, but this will be a parking lot. And I said, pull the bus over. So he started pulling the bus over, and he opens the door, and I'm going outside. I get around to the front of the bus. Just as I get to the front of the bus, the windshield falls. Now, we're not talking about automobile window here, people. We're talking the window in the front of the bus where the driver is coming out. I am on a main highway in Canada holding the windshield of a bus. Now, if you want to feel truly stupid, stand in another country holding the windshield of a damn bus.
You do make an interesting hood.
That's dumb. Here, this guy is on the inside trying to hold the window. I'm on the outside trying to hold the window, and I'm saying somebody better get their butt out here because this is not going to work. Because I'm not going to stand out here all the way to Philadelphia holding this windshield, you understand? So, hey, come outside. We take the windshield down from the bus. And if you think that this did not cause some amount of curiosity and consternation on the part of the people driving by, here you have six people holding the windshield like pallbearers about to put it into the luggage compartment of the bus. And people are going, what the hell are they doing? So, oh, who knows? They're crazy Yanks, you know. We're putting the windshield, and we turn around, and now you have to understand, the bus driver is driving the bus. The rain is coming in on the bus driver. The windshield wipers are turning because he had to have a windshield wiper for the other side of the window. So there's no window in front of the bus driver, and the windshield is going. And the bus driver is going, can somebody give me a towel? Towel, hell! wrap you in saran wrap, man. This guy is getting soaked. He looked like he did Dee Dee on his pants. And, you know, we're turning around, coming back. We drive into this bus place, you know, into this bus garage. As we're driving in, here we, there's a French word for things that we say when people have to go make caca, you know, and they said that word. We walked in, we're driving in, and the Frenchman said, what? That's the word. It sounds like made with an R on it. And we're driving the bus in, and they're going, what the hell? And no windshield, and the windshield wiper's going, and the bus driver is soaked, and he's going, what? I'm wet, man, I'm wet. And we drive up in it, and they go, did it break? Said, no, it fell out. And they started laughing. You know, they're laughing. Said, how the hell did it fall out? Now, if anybody knew how the windshield fell out, hell, you would have prevented it, right? Why ask a dumb question like that? People don't live that far across our border. Why they ask the stupid question? Why did it fall out? Why? Who knows why? So now they got to try and it's Sunday. Sunday in Catholic Montreal. All right, we need a glazer. We need a glazer to put a window back in a bus. Mechanics are there, metal workers are there, guys can change tires are there. You know, guys can rebuild the whole bus. Not one glazer in the building. Guy said, I think it is going to be most difficult. That's no lie.
That's not what you said.
Yeah, that's right.
That's not what you said.
Some lady came up to me and she said, and what are we going to do? I said, honey, if I knew that, I'd play a number. You know, I'd really jump ahead of the game. You know, I don't know. You know, what you want me? I can call my mom. You know, I don't know. So now we're sitting around. Now we're trying to figure out what's going on. Do you believe they found a glazer and his son?
A glazer and his son.
And they came and they put the window back in the bus.